Okay, so today I'm really excited because I've got a great video for you guys, and it's been a long time in the making. It's about a molecule, a protein molecule, that might have a huge capacity to rejuvenate aging tissue. Now, this molecule already exists in our bodies, but it might be something that you've never heard of, GDF11. If you watch this video, you're going to learn all about it. This is something that I'm really excited about. GDF11 might actually be able to move the needle on rejuvenation. And not just move it a little. GDF11 might be able to move it a lot. And it might make a big difference in restoring and rejuvenating aging tissues. We're going to be looking at what GDF11 is and how it works. We'll examine some of the claims that have been made regarding the potential benefits of GDF11 on aging. And we'll talk about some of the controversial research that's been done on GDF11. And finally, we'll take a look at one citizen scientist and some of his amazing research and experiments into aging and longevity with GDF11. Now, I gotta admit, this is one of the longest videos that I've ever done. But if you hang in there until the very end, I promise you, there's gonna be a ton of great information in this video. Okay, let's start this discussion by talking about what GDF11 is. GDF11 is a protein, and it stands for growth differentiation factor 11. So GDF11 is a growth factor. GDF11 is also known as bone morphogenic protein 11, or BMP11, and it's encoded by the GDF11 gene. It acts as a cytokine, which is a loose category of small peptides that are important for cell signaling. GDF11 is very similar in structure to myostatin, also known as GDF8, and it can sometimes be difficult to distinguish between the two in the lab, as you'll see when we get into some of the controversy caused by various studies on GDF11. Now, growth, as it relates to cells, can be anything from growing new muscle tissue to cellular repair. And growth is regulated and coordinated by communication between the cells, which takes the form of chemical signaling, also known as intracellular communication. And the loss of intracellular communication is one of the hallmarks of aging. Growth factors are signaling peptide molecules that can either positively or negatively regulate the proliferation, differentiation, migration, and the very survival of cells and tissue. They're kind of like hormones because they circulate through the blood and are carried to their target cells or tissues. However, hormones can only be secreted by specific glandular tissue, whereas growth factors can be produced by every cell in the body. There's a lot of different types of growth factors, and they're divided into several superfamilies. Transforming growth factor beta, also known as TGF-beta, is one of the better-known superfamilies, and GDF11 is a member of TGF-beta. One of GDF11's primary functions is to activate the repair of DNA in stem cells. Now, I've talked about the damage to the DNA of stem cells before, and this is a big deal because it's crucial for regulating the network of blood vessels that provide your organs and tissues with a steady stream of healthy blood. A study has shown that getting more blood to your organs could have a rejuvenating effect on a number of body systems. So a lot of studies have been conducted on GDF11 over the years, and they've shown that GDF11 can have a huge impact on the aging process, or at least some of them have shown that. Some of them have shown just the opposite, but more on that a little later. Now, almost all of these studies have been conducted on mice and rats, with only a few done on humans. But the GDF11 in mice and rats is identical to the GDF11 found in humans. And most of the human studies have backed up the findings in studies done on mice and rats. Now, I'm not going to go into all of the beneficial effects of GDF11 on aging, because quite frankly, there are just too many. I'm only going to cover what I consider to be some of the most important. Systemic GDF11 treatment improves the vasculature in the hippocampus and the cortex of old mice, resulting in enhanced neurogenesis, while loss of GDF11 shortens telomere length by downregulating telomerase activity. Now, several studies have shown that GDF11 can improve the metabolism of glucose, restore the insulin IFG1 signaling pathway, and stimulate adiponectin secretion, potentially alleviating obesity, hyperglycemia, insulin resistance, and fatty liver development. GDF11 enhances therapeutic efficacy of mesenchymal stem cells in heart muscle. Now, this novel approach for GDF11 may be used for a new approach to stem cell therapy in myocardial infarctions. GDF11 improves endothelial dysfunction, decreases endothelial apoptosis, and reduces inflammation, consequently decreasing arteriosclerotic plaques. GDF11 decreases liver fibrosis through the expansion of liver progenitor cells, another type of stem cell. The protective role of GDF11 during liver fibrosis suggests a potential application of GDF11 for the treatment of chronic liver disease. Numerous studies have demonstrated GDF11's considerable anti-aging effects on the skin. It's a regulator of skin biology, and it can boost the production of procollagen 1 and hyaluronic acid, and it can improve skin endothelial cells and skin vasculature. GDF11 has been found to reduce oxidative stress and was able to reduce the levels of advanced glycation end products, protein oxidation, and lipid peroxidation, and to slow down the accumulation of age-related histological markers. GDF11 can also cause a lowering of blood pressure, apparently because it can cause an increase in the expression of an enzyme necessary for relaxation during diastolic functions. Now, levels of systemic GDF11 normally decline with age. In 2014, at the Harvard Stem Cell Institute, Richard Lee and Amy Wagers conducted experiments where they grafted older mice to younger mice so that both mice shared a single blood supply. Now, this is called heterochronic parabiosis, and they found that they were able to reverse impairments to functionality and to restore the age-related damage to DNA in stem cells, in muscle stem cells, also known as satellite cells. This improved overall muscle structure, and it increased the capacity for both strength and endurance exercises. In the same experiment, Lee and Wagers were also able to reverse cardiac hypertrophy. You see, the heart gets bigger with age, succumbing to unhealthy hypertrophy. But in the parabiosis experiment, the hearts of the older mice literally shrunk in size and came to resemble the hearts of the young mice. In another study, researchers were able to recreate the rejuvenation effects of parabiosis in old mice and to reverse age-related hypertrophy by simply restoring GDF11 to youthful levels using supplementation. Wagers and Lee continued their research at the Harvard Stem Cell Institute, finding that GDF11 is also capable of restoring muscle cell activity and enhancing muscle regeneration following damage. Now, that means that GDF11 can help reverse sarcopenia. At the same time as the experiments with Wagers and Lee in 2014, another study found that GDF11 can reverse the aging process in the brain. When it was injected into older mice, their brain stem cells increased in number. New blood vessels emerged, and the improved cerebral blood flow increased the animal's cognitive abilities. Not only did the mice get smarter, but their senses improved. Once on supplemental GDF11, the elderly mice's sense of smell was restored, back to a level that was comparable to young mice. This means that GDF11 can potentially stimulate the growth of both nerves and blood vessels. This opens the door to healing damage to the neurons, counteracting neurodegeneration, improving neuroplasticity, and maybe even treating mood and affective disorders. Finally, in humans, even though the levels of GDF11 can go into decline as you age, it's been demonstrated that older males who've been active over the course of their lives show higher levels of GDF11 than in inactive older men. So, as you age, your activity level can determine the levels of GDF11 present in your bloodstream. These results, combined with all the results that I mentioned previously, have led to claims that GDF11 may be a factor in longevity rejuvenation. However, there's been some controversy surrounding these findings. Another publication concluded that GDF11 actually increases with age and can have harmful effects on skeletal muscle regeneration. However, in October of 2015, A Harvard study demonstrated that these contrary findings were the result of a flawed assay that was detecting immunoglobulin and not GDF-11. The Harvard study claimed that GDF-11 does in fact reverse age-related cardiac hypertrophy. However, the Harvard study both ignored the GDF-11 specific assay that was developed, establishing that GDF-11 in mice is undetectable and that the factor measured was in fact myostatin, or GDF-8. GDF-11 has also shown remarkable properties in the fight against cancer, although these findings are also controversial. On the one hand, GDF-11 has been found to have a therapeutic effect on various cancers, since it regulates the differentiation of stem cells, a key progenitor of cancer progression. It may help to suppress growing tumors. In fact, some studies show that GDF-11 can suppress tumors in both liver and pancreatic tissue, and that elevated GDF-11 levels can promote apoptosis in pancreatic cancer cells. However, in another study, 130 patients with colorectal cancer, in which the expression of GDF-11 was significantly higher compared with normal tissue, they found a higher frequency of lymph node metastasis, more deaths, and a lower survival rate. Now, this study suggests that GDF-11 could be a prognostic biomarker in patients with this disease. And according to the Human Protein Atlas database, GDF-11 has been linked to breast, colorectal, liver, and pancreatic cancers. Another area of controversy is bone formation. Now, I mentioned earlier that GDF-11 is also known as BMP-11, or bone morphogenic protein 11, and it plays an essential role in growing new bone material. Now here, scientific research yields opposite conclusions. On the one hand, quite a lot of studies indicate that GDF-11 plays a negative role. In a study of mice in 2016, GDF-11 was found to inhibit bone formation and hasten age-related bone loss, both for young adult and aged mice. On the other hand, in 2015, another team of researchers took a look at bone marrow of both aging mice and mice with osteoporosis and found that the concentrations of GDF-11 were significantly decreased. The scientists concluded that GDF-11 is critical for bone homeostasis, and they even hypothesized that bone fragility may be reduced by GDF-11 supplementation. Suffice it to say that the research around GDF-11 has been rife with controversy, and this debate is still being waged, with claims and counterclaims being fired back and forth by both sides. So here's my read on this debate. Because of flaws in the assay of GDF-11, and in being able to distinguish between GDF-11 and GDF-8, it's unknown whether GDF-11 can prevent cardiac hypertrophy or cause it. It's still undetermined whether concentrations of GDF-11 are higher or lower in various cancers, and whether or not it causes or prevents osteoporosis. But after looking at all of the controversy, I feel that GDF-11's track record in repairing DNA damage to stem cells, its effects on aging skin, and several other benefits are pretty much undisputed. Okay, so in the face of all this debate and controversy, one brave soul has decided to put it to the test on himself. And his name is Steve Perry. Now, this is not the lead singer for Journey. This is another Steve Perry. For the last several years, Steve Perry has been conducting his own clinical trial on using supplemental GDF-11. Now, I suppose the term clinical trial is a little inappropriate because Steve is a citizen scientist and he doesn't have his own clinic. He's not a medical doctor and he doesn't have a PhD. Nonetheless, he's been conducting an ongoing trial for several years now and he's recruited quite a few other biohackers and DIYers to join him. And this group has shown some remarkable results and collected quite a trove of data. Steve was convinced by a lot of the studies that I've mentioned in this video, but his rationale was also based on data coming back from organ transplants. If you take an organ from an older person and give it to a younger person who obviously has a higher concentration of GDF-11, that older organ will usually become considerably rejuvenated over time. And apparently, Steve thought GDF-11 was the reason why. So, Steve became patient zero of GDF-11 supplementation in humans. Now, when Steve started out, there were no guidelines to go by, no blueprint on how to go about this. So, it was trial and error for Steve. Now, it turns out, supplementing with GDF-11 isn't lethal, thank God. But if you don't do it right, it can be uncomfortable. If you do too much GDF-11, you can get elevated blood pressure, shortness of breath, insomnia, acid reflux, and in rare cases, heart arrhythmia. By means of trial and error, Steve landed on the right protocol for supplementation. After observing some remarkable positive changes, he decided to invite other longevity enthusiasts into the study. He gathered a cohort of volunteers who all took GDF-11, tracked several different biomarkers, and logged their dosage and biomarkers every day. So far, more than 100 people have decided to join Steve's trial, and they've yielded a substantial amount of data. And they found that they started to turn in results that were mirroring the results of a lot of the mouse studies that I've already talked about. They started experiencing improvements in their cardiovascular system. They started putting on muscle. Their hearing, vision, and sense of smell started to improve. And their biomarkers improved as well. Biomarkers for arterial elasticity went up by 64%. For most of the participants, carotid artery thickness went down, and one of the participants witnessed a reversal of his arterial plaque. Heart rate variability improved on average by 22%. Blood pressure was reduced by 5.7%, and pulse rate went down by 6.3%. Their skin got more elastic. Improvements measured with a cutometer were up to 17.4%, and participants reported feeling fitter, having greater endurance and more energy, and most of them also gained more lean muscle mass. Their reaction time, something that normally declines with age, improved. What's more, it improved for all of the participants, with an average of 12.45%. Same thing happened for other markers for breathing and the immune system. Steve's protocol is based on close observation of the feedback you get from your own body. If you choose to join their study, they send you a number of devices for tracking various biomarkers on a daily basis. They send you an MFIT sleep tracking monitor, a blood pressure and pulse monitor, a spirometer for measuring lung function, a glucose monitor, a Camry digital hand dynamometer for measuring grip strength, a Bluetooth body fat scale and body composition analyzer, and a thermometer for measuring your waking body temperature. They also provide you with a link for measuring your reaction time and another for downloading a phone app that measures your hearing. They also provide a formula for diluting the GDF-11 for injection. Yes, the GDF-11 has to be injected. It's not available in oral form. They also provide spreadsheets for tracking your biomarkers. Now, if you want to join their study, it's going to cost you about $15,000. Now, I know that's really steep, but they're very free with the information about how to conduct the study. And if you decide you want to try it on your own, you can. All of the devices for tracking your biomarkers are readily available. You can download both the dilution formula and the spreadsheets, even if you don't officially join their study. I corresponded with Steve, and he didn't really recommend doing it on your own. However, he did say that it can be done, and he provided me with a source for the GDF-11, and I'll put that source in the description below. I'll also put a link to Steve's website, where you can find a ton of information. Now, they're also starting to combine the peptide Clotho with GDF-11, and I'll be doing another video shortly on Clotho. Now, I'll be honest with you, I can't afford the 15 grand to join Steve's study, but I feel pretty confident that with all the information that he's provided, I'm savvy enough to be able to do it anyway. Now, I haven't decided to do it yet, but if I do, I'll let you guys know, and I'll put up a video with my results. And that's it for me and for this video. Thanks for hanging in there until the end. I'm out of here. Catch you next time.